Even if you think your dog won't bite somebody, there are some places where they will need to wear a muzzle, for instance, the vet's office. Having your dog comfortable wearing the muzzle means that that is not an anxiety-inducing experience for them. My name is Joe, and I'm head of animal welfare here at People Farm. And this is Chili Dog, who's my dog, and I'm going to be teaching him to wear the muzzle today. First, I'm going to start just by getting his attention on me with some of his favorite treats. If your dog isn't a foodie and isn't really all that excited about treats, make sure to do this before they have their meal so they're nice and hungry. Once I know I have his attention, I'm gonna take my muzzle, which I've gone with a muzzle that's a couple sizes too big to start. That way he's more comfortable putting his face in it. I take his favorite treat and I put it right in the front of the muzzle where his nose will go. Chili. Then I offer it to him. You might have to point out that the treat is in there. He'll even try and get it from the outside. Just gently put it in front of his face again so that he knows he has to go in from the front to get it. Now I'm just gonna repeat this over and over again until he immediately just shoves his face straight in the muzzle. Remember not to rush this process. We just want them comfortable putting their nose into the basket and out of the basket over and over again. I'm gonna keep doing this with Chili for a full week.
1 week later.
This week, we're gonna try the next step. So first I take the muzzle, same as last week. I put the treat in the bottom, like this. And then I offer it to Chili. You can even, if you have a muzzle that allows it, take food and put it through the gaps in the front. And just continuously feed through the front of the muzzle so that he gets used to his face just staying inside constantly. Here we go. And this time I'm just gonna put the strap around his head while he's eating the food. And then I repeat that. And this is just to get him comfortable with the strap going around his head. He's still eating food while I'm doing the strap. And that way he associates the strap with something positive and yummy. You can see after a week of working with him, Chili is super comfortable with having his face in the muzzle and having the strap going around his head. He's desensitized to this now. If your dog seems really comfortable with all of this, with the strap going on, he's not pulling his head out at all, the next step is to make sure you have a bunch of food ready. Get him with his face in the muzzle. And then snapping it on. Now you can see he's wearing it. I want to take it off really quickly though, so that he doesn't ever get the chance to panic. You'll also notice that when I put it on, it's extremely loose on him. Right now, I'm not tightening this strap down. I just want him comfortable with the strap feeling on the back of his head. And there you have it. That's the next step in teaching your dog to wear a muzzle.
1 week later.
This week, we're actually going to snap the muzzle and have it completely closed and ready. So you'll notice I have gauze on my muzzle this time because my strap broke since we were practicing so much. We're going to do a little warm up. Here we go, good boy. So now that Chili's comfortable with this and he seems pretty comfortable with it around the back of his head, I have adjusted this muzzle to the size of his head. You can start loose if you want and then adjust it later as he gets more comfortable. So this time I'm gonna snap it closed. I'm gonna have lots of treats ready in one hand and get him prepared by shoving some treats through the muzzle. And this just gets him focused on eating and less on what's happening around the back of his head. So I'm gonna squeeze one through, clip the muzzle together, hold on to it and continually feed them through so I'm not giving him a chance to think about the fact that the muzzle's on his face. This is a really, really great start. He's doing really good. This is the longest I've ever had him in this muzzle. And he's not even thinking about the muzzle, he's just thinking about the treats. And as soon as he's done, before he can get to the point where he's panicking about having the muzzle on his face, so if you're running out of treats, take it off right away. Then I take it off and I reward him for wearing it. Good boy. You want to repeat this over and over and over again with longer stretches of time with him wearing the muzzle. The key is to start small and build up from there. Eventually, your dog will wear a muzzle and not even think about having it on. And there you have it, 3 simple steps to teach your dog to wear a muzzle comfortably. Your dog should not be wearing a muzzle all day and should never be wearing a muzzle unattended. So never leave your dog alone with the muzzle on. However, if you're going to the vet's office, or say you're going for a couple hours on an outing and your dog is reactive with new people or new dogs and you're afraid that he might bite, you can leave the muzzle on while you're out and about for a few hours. It only becomes cruel when you're leaving your dog in the muzzle for too long or when you're leaving them without anybody watching them. The most important thing is to make sure you are getting the correct type of muzzle. If your muzzle holds your dog's mouth shut and they cannot open their mouth, they can't pant, they can't drink water, and they can't eat through the muzzle, your muzzle should not be left on for more than a few minutes at a time. My favorite basket type muzzle is from the brand called Baskerville, and these are available on Amazon. If you have any questions about this process, or if you've struggled with some part or another with your dog, make sure to put it in the comments below and I'll answer it as soon as I can.